Hi, I'm Koos Eisen. I'm responsible for the drawing classes at the Faculty of Industrial Design Engineering in Delft. Together with Rosalien Sturr, I'm the author of worldwide best-selling books about sketching. Just last month, we presented Sketching Product Design Presentation. With the Delft Design Drawing staff, we teach students in making informative drawings in side views as well as in perspective, on paper but also digitally. With a combination of pictures, drawings and text, we aim for as much visual communication as possible. The goal of this exercise is to teach you making drawings or sketches in side view with a little experience and with a minimum of sketching tools. Please work with me in this exercise. For a start, you need a fineliner or a ballpoint. Drawings are most likely to express a design within a context. We will focus on coffee drinking, which is partially experience and partially product related. So designing a coffee cup and adding an environment to it. I will show you the use of a gray pastel to add the suggestion of volume to a line drawing. If you have little experience in drawing, don't worry. Have above all fun with the exercise. First, we are going to make pictures. Everybody has a cell phone nowadays, so you can easily make a picture of a hand and a cup. So make a print using tracer paper, quickly make an acceptable drawing, as you can see. So the hands should be in outlines and the cup should be in side view. So you make the major lines, the center line, the contours, and that's actually it. The funny part of it, that you actually have drawn two hands. One left hand if you turn the page. So now we use marker paper to again trace the drawing. You could also find some pictures where you try to express the use and the context of your design. So first of all, we're going to explain something about the basics. A cup is actually a sort of cylinder. You have a central axis and two tangents and two ellipses. I will show you. First, the tangent lines, the central axis and two ellipses. One at the bottom, one at the top. A smooth ongoing line creates a smooth sort of drawing. You can also add shading to it using a little bit of volume. I use a marker. Here you can see the shading in it. So if you would have a side view of a cylinder, you cannot see actually that it's round. What to do with that? Of course, you could use shading. So again, you take the marker and make a gradient as if the light is coming from the left side. You see? If you have a special change of the surface, like for instance the bottom is a little bit round, you could again start with the tangent lines and the center axis, and now you have a curvature underneath. What to do with it? Well, if you have the mark again, you should be able to change shading. So next step. If you want to draw a coffee cup, you can again start with a perspective drawing of it. And now you need a grip. So if you normally are a little, if you have hardly any experience in drawing, you will probably make something which is a lookalike of the small sketch which I'm making right now. So you actually cannot see the connection between the grip and the cup. In perspective, you make a cross section through the object, and then you need a tangent line to be able to make the handle in perspective correctly. So be aware, the perspective line should be to the same vanishing point. There are a lot of lines needed, so it's beneficial to add shading to express the volume of the cup, as you can see. And because it's open, you also have a little bit of shading inside the cup, maybe a little bit of cast shadow, but that's knowledge-based. So first of all, this is what you can do if you add something to a cylinder. So if you have a cylinder in a different position, you still need the tension lines, you can see, to attach a grip to a cylinder. The basic idea is that there's a general rule. You start with the central X, have a 90 degree major X to it, and then try to figure out where the tensions are. So in the three examples, you can see that you're more or less free in the starting point of the cylinder. The rule is generally that you need a tension line. But we are going to focus on the sketches, because it's a lot of fun to make insightful drawings, a lot of sketches, just getting some ideas. I always start with a center line, trying to make the tension lines in it. Don't think too loudly, just trying to get as much ideas as I can in a minimum of time. Different grips to the cup, but the shape of the cup could also be different. Don't be scared about the lines. They sometimes crossing other drawings. It gets more a lively view by doing so, and it's less static. So the advice is to make a lot of drawings. In this example, you can see there are about 8 drawings on a piece of paper. So maybe in a quarter of an hour, you get 2 or 3 sheets of paper. Adding some shading to it is done now with pastel. And you can see the drawing lines change into volumes. And it's only because you have to value which kind of idea is better to work out. You could, of course, use a marker. Do more or less the same with it. So a cast shadow here. Maybe your bottom line could be a little bit stronger. But that's actually it. Maybe a cast shadow if you don't. So a little bit of theory about shading. If you have an object which is partially having cone shapes, maybe cylinders, spheres, cone shapes upside down. What is then the benefit of shading? Well, in the theory, I could show you the construction of cast shadows and about shading. And something interesting is starting. The edges of the shading jump. They're not parallel to the shape. So an exercise could be, if you have a long row of different basic shapes, to think over, should there be more or lesser shading in a drawing? So the cylinder, for instance, has more shading than the top drawn cone shape. This is a round shape, which could be regarded as difficult, but if you have a sphere like that, you can just think about a highlighted part and a sort of moon shape shading. And this moon shape shading is used here as an information, just a cutoff of a small part of this sphere. So ongoing, again, you will meet small things like a cast shadow. The cylinder would look the same as the other cylinders. And finally, this is the result. The edges of the shading jump from one direction to another and are never parallel to the shape. So now we're going to make the design. So I prepared already the traced version, and now you see the cup is not exactly tracing the original one, but it's my proposal. But it's immediately within the environment. So the experience is expressed by adding a person to it, maybe a family behind it, but still we want to focus on your idea, and you get the context for free because it's just tracing some of your pictures you made. Of course, the product in your product design is the most important part. So the context is something in relation to the project. So we're going to shade a little bit of the proposal, and maybe you could finalize the drawing by adding a little bit of shading to the person next to the cup. But just a hint which create the effect that the person is nearer to you and the cup is nearer to you and the rest is actually environment. And of course you could add some color if you have, but that actually concludes the exercise. For now, thanks for watching. I hope it inspired you. Keep on practicing.